Hi everybody, welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Louise and I'm a full-time reseller on eBay, Poshmark, and occasionally Etsy. And I am doing a video today about my inventory system. I have gotten a few requests or questions about how I utilize the blue IKEA bags and how much fits in them and you know, how easy it is to manage storing inventory in them. I will say that prior to using the IKEA bags, I did use plastic, you know, bins with the snap-on lids. Those didn't work for me for a couple of reasons. One is that because I'm kind of scrappy and thrifty, I did not buy all matching ones that were all the same size. And so they were, you know, all different ones kind of jarbled together. And unfortunately, the size that I had the most of, which is just that standard, you know, those ones you see in everybody's inventory videos, I could not fit three of them side by side on my shelving units. And so I could only fit two of them and then one kind of smaller one, but then there was excess space that wasn't being used up. Anyway, so I switched to the IKEA bags because they're squishy, so I can squish three on every shelf. It utilizes literally every inch of the shelf space. And also they are lighter, they're less awkward. I can kind of tip the top ones down a little bit to dig through them if I need to. It's easy to get my inventory to go in order, like in SKU order, so it's very easy to pull the items out. So this is the start of my inventory system. At the very beginning, my the first step after I get my sourced items to my office is that I hang, we're talking about clothing specifically, housewares or hard goods have their own system, but clothing gets hung on hangers so that my photographer knows that's the stuff that needs to get photographed. She photographs and measures and then folds the items and puts them on a table next to the hanging rack. And then when I come in to work, I just grab a stack of clothes. You know, this is a pair of pants that she has already photographed and measured. So I go ahead and list the item and then I just fold it. I use plastic bags that I reuse. So when I go to ship an item, I pull it. And then I put the plastic bag in a bin and I reuse them over and over again. So it is plastic, but it's not single use. I've been using the same bags for over a year. So then I just seal it up, squish the air out. I cut up my thermal labels, label printer labels, to use as stick-on labels because they don't peel off from the plastic bag, and like the address labels always were peeling off. It was very frustrating. So I just do this, I stick it on there. I keep track of where I am on a sticky note so that I know where, what number to pick up with. I put this on here and then it will go into a blue IKEA bag in order. So I will pop over and show you what that looks like. Maybe I'll just take you with me. That's a little bit awkward. There's my finger. Okay, so then I utilize my center, that's the rack where I hang clothes waiting to be photographed, and then I use my center table to organize. So you can see the IKEA bags are just all here. I'm gonna see if I can, I don't think I can flip it around in the middle of a video. So they are all organized in here. So see, this is CW, and it'll just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 all the way down. So I can fit every SKU letter, so like CW has 25. So every starts with A, goes to Z, then AA through AZ, then B, you know, and every letter combination has 25 numbers. So I can fit, if there are no bulky sweaters or coats, I can fit 2 letter SKUs or 50 items per blue IKEA bag. You will see some of them become much less full, right? So over time, I will combine letters together, once every few months, I go through and combine all the letters to utilize the space the best that I can. So that's what I do. I use the plastic bags. They go into the IKEA bags. I have my center work table so that I can just pull an IKEA bag out, put it on the center table, unzip it, grab what I need, and put it back. It's very quick. I can get my hands on most items. I have about 1,300 items in these bags. And I can get my hand on most items within 30 seconds, maybe a little bit longer. When I used the bins, everything was just tossed in there. There was no way to organize them inside the bin that worked for me. And so I often wound up having to dig through the bin. And when they were up high, they were hard to get down. And then you had to kind of like fight them on the lip of the shelves. It's just much easier for me to do it this way. How do you store your inventory? Are you a bin person? Are you a bag person? Are you a hanging person? How do you sort it? What do you think are the benefits of how you do it? It's one of the things I'm the most curious about is how people store all this stuff. I am lucky because I do have a separate space outside of my home that I can utilize, you know, every inch of to be as organized as I can be. I guess that's the end of this short little video. Please let me know how you do your inventory. I would love to hear about it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not already. I'm gonna try and be back here more. We have worked out a schedule for my family now where I've got it figured out so I can actually devote a little bit more time to this whole deal. So subscribe if you're not. I am hoping to do more little videos about my process because it's one of the things that I watch the most of myself from other resellers just to learn how they're doing things. Yeah, I might have some hauls and things like that, but I think I'm gonna try and focus on, do a series on my process and what my process looks like, and maybe that will help other people. So have a great day. Thanks for tuning in, and I hope to see you soon.